In today's episode, we're sculpting this, which means we're carving this into this. We'll show you how we do it, work some mad detailing magic, recap our sculpture, and dazzle you with breathtaking cinematics. Looking for top 5 entertainment for the next 50 minutes? Then park it right here and stick around. Hey, good morning, good day, good afternoon, and good evening. Welcome back to the channel. I'm your host, City Sculptor, and you have made your way back to Pengasas Bay. Hey, it's great to have you here. And we're looking at the subject of today's build, which is Southpass Isle. Yeah, Southpass Isle right here. And that gets its name because it is kind of the base, the southern entrance, if you will, of the Baypass Tunnel. Now, as I zoom down in here, you may recall we built out the Baypass Tunnel many, many episodes, probably 20 episodes ago at least. And this is a dual-purpose tunnel that serves as a freeway entrance, freeway enclosure, and also supports our rail line as it makes its way from the outer barrier aisle back into Pengasas Bay proper. So we dive our way underneath the bay, wave to the cruise ships that are going by, and the freeway emerges over here in this area, and then the train emerges from this beautiful conch shell train enclosure that we built out as well as we laid out our downtown. But jumping back over to the South Pass Isle, you can see it's not a big piece of land, but I thought this would be a really good use for us to drop in some high-rise residential and maybe some medium-rise as residential as well, maybe a few exclusive homes along the way as well, if I can squeeze those in as well. I thought this would be a fantastic location to look in across to downtown and maybe sits as a nice complement to one of our future episodes when we start to build out our consular district over here. All right, well, I just threw a lot at you guys, and I can't wait to dive in and get this thing rolling. So with all that as a backdrop, let's do this. So as I look at Southpass Isle, I see two distinct sides, right? You've got this little narrow strip here that's along the east side. And then you've got on the west side, you've got this little larger chunk over here. And I thought, how am I going to connect these two? There's really no easy way to do it. I don't have a way to come through here unless I create a tunnel. And I didn't want to create a tunnel like that. But I thought, you know, let's take a look over here. And I noticed this little poplar street that extends out of our immigration district. You know, you remember Gateway Village that we built many, many episodes ago. That was what, episode 3, maybe 2? I don't know. It's a long time ago. And we've got this poplar street, and I thought, well, let's create like a little crossing that comes over here and bends its way up along the freeway. And then I could put in almost like a little gated community in here with some beautiful estates. And then I could tie into this retaining wall that is, you know, actually a walking path that's serving as a retaining wall and create some pedestrian access that allows you to come all the way down along here out to some of these shops that are out here on the end, and then make your way through the decorative gardens and then come back across over here. Now, maybe I can figure out a way to suspend a walking path over the top of it too. That might be kind of neat. Anyhow, that's how we'll get our auto access over onto this side. And then on this side, I wanted to come in here and tie into this road that's coming in from our farming and timber district. Just, you know, use this intersection as it is, create a little overpass here, I should say, or just a crossing, if you will. And then also over here from our consular district, just tap into this little road network that's coming over here, have this come out here, and then maybe we'll wind out along and reconnect back over there. So why don't you guys sit tight? Let me build out that road network for us. So now with those access roads in place, you've got the one on the east side coming in over here, and then the one on the west side that reconnects back to the consular district. I like the way that looks. Let's start to build out the road network down in this little notch here. Now, one of the things I want to do is I want to create this canal effect that's going on this side over here. And the best way I think to do that is to just grab a level terrain tool, maybe set our brush size down to about 60, capture this elevation and push this out. Push this out so it's almost all the way across. And not to worry, we'll come back in a little bit and reestablish that canal. If I push that out so that it's all the way across to the other side, then what that allows us to do is come back in and dig this out and establish a little waterfront road. So the way we do that is we once again grab our level terrain tool. We're going to set our brush size this time to maybe, let's do 30. Let's see if that'll work. And then we're going to set an elevation that's 1, 2, 3 contour lines below sea level and just start digging this out. Let's just kind of come right down from here. Let's not get too close to the water because I don't want it to flood or run across. Yeah, something like that. And so now with that in place, we can drop in our retaining wall road. And the way I'm going to do this, I'm going to take a large road, a 6-lane road here. I want to decrease my steps, and then I want to turn off the snap to guidelines and come right into here and elevate this up so that the retaining wall mechanic starts to activate. In fact, I may have to, as much as I'd love to be straight in with that one there, I think I'm going to have to kind of get cute with this and just freeform it. So I'll do so by coming in just to a point where you can see the terrain starts to buckle like that when I slide down there. Maybe I'll just leave this up a little bit further. And then we'll run out in this direction here, just to about here. And you can see that I want to try and keep that elevation as level as possible. Try not to lose any of this pavement to that kind of that buckling effect. There you go. -1. That's pretty darn good. And then we'll just turn on our little continuous curve here. I want to start with a right angle. So I'm coming off in this direction and bend up to this way here. And then I'll turn the right angles off. And you can see I just get it back to where it's about even. Turn our right angle back on and come out. Pick a snap point. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. That's terrible. Well, let's see if we can disengage that. We can. Cool. And then we can come back in here and snap to that point. Let's turn off these. Yeah, to that end piece there. Good. I think we might have saved the day. We're going to turn the 90 degree on. We're going to come out and select our angle, turn the 90 degree off. And this is kind of a cat and mouse game where you just have to very gently, in small, small increments, continue to build your road segments so that ultimately it looks nice and level. Yeah, there. Now you can see that it's locked in there and it's got some kind of a funky shape to it, but I think that's going to be okay. And then we can come back in with our pedestrian road. And we are just going to go ahead and we're going to replace this existing 6-lane road with this pedestrian road. Yeah, like that. And let's turn this back on and check out our contour lines. You can see that we're pretty darn close to level with all of those. There's a little tearing that's going on there, but I think if I come in here and smooth it out, it'll fill in right nicely. Let's just take our level terrain tool and push these out. Yeah, there. And it's nice and level. And what this allowed us to do is to... you know, in the not too distant future here, we'll peel back this wall and then we'll have a nice little canal that runs back through here. So we've reestablished that. All right, very cool. Let's start building in the rest of the road network. Now to build out that road network, I'm going to come out of some key intersection points here. And I need to take this level terrain tool and press this higher elevation out to here and then maybe out to here again. And then let's find a couple more. Let's see, 1, 2... well, maybe we'll do it down here at the very end if we can. I don't know. And then we'll come into let's do it here. Let's do it here. And just make sure that this is pressed out quite a ways so that as I attach roads to it, and I'm going to continue with the pedestrian roads, as I attach a road to this, we start coming back in here. I don't fire up key walls on the exterior sides of this pedestrian road. So I'm just going to come out like so. And let's see if we can do the end piece down here. And then we'll come into these corners. And let's do this end piece here as well. Yeah. Now we've established pedestrian access kind of out to this this outer wall here as well. And then we can start to build in just regular, just regular roads coming into here. Let's do that next. I'll grab just a regular two-lane road, run straight off of here and come straight out to here. Will that connect? Ooh, it's pretty close. Let's just go ahead and connect it anyhow. And then we'll run this one straight across in this direction here. Yeah. And then I'm going to bring this right straight out into this road. We'll come across here and do the same. Let's see here. Let's just run straight across the top here and connect this one out to here. There we go. Yeah, we've got a lot of busted grids, but we can figure that out. Okay, cool. Let's now come back in here and work through the internal part of our grid. Yeah, there, now we've got a nice little grid pattern in here, and this is gonna be pretty cool, I think. And so now let's drop in some parking. I think we could drop in a little parking lot down here. This is gonna be, again, all this medium and high density residential. I think we're gonna need quite a bit of parking. Let's see if that fits in there. It does just fit into that spot. Okay, cool. And then now we'll run over here, kind of in that other corner, if you will, and see if we can squeeze something in there. Does a large one fit in there? It doesn't. Okay, that's fine. Let's do a medium then. We'll put a medium parking lot right up against the neighborhood here, which is fine. I love that we can come in and adjust that surface. Here, let's just do that again real quick. Let's take this. Let's see here. Click on the surface. This is so cool. Just drag that right out there. Yeah, look at that. Okay, pull this out. Yeah, that's pretty cool. All right. And I think we need one more parking lot, maybe kind of in the middle section here. I don't know how many parking lots we're going to need. This is probably good. Just one more large parking lot. And maybe I'll put it right. Yeah, let's do that. We'll put a large parking lot down in there because we're going to have, my vision is we're going to have some row homes down here. A nice little park in the corner. Maybe some shopping in there, kind of a funky space, and some more row homes there. Some high rise back in here and here, and then medium density kind of along this curve here. So let's get to work on doing all of those. Now, public transit is something we should probably think about since we're going to have such a high density in this little spot. And I'm thinking maybe a little bus depot or, bus station, I should say, in here. Turn off that snap to guidelines, bring this guy out. I'm going to turn off snap to grid at this point and just bring this out to here and then have that connect into there. And now we've got this brand new little bus station that just came out, a small bus station with one of our recent patches. And there we go. We're going to drop that right in there. That nestles into that corner really nicely, is going to give us access to this whole little neighborhood out here. Very cool. All right, now let's start down in this section with some row houses. Row homes. North American, okay, yeah, let's go with European style. I want to use our little, kind of our zipper pattern that we've used here in a couple places. Yeah, like that. I think that's going to be a good start. And then let's put a little height in over here, huh? What do you say? Let's take a European style high density and drop that in, maybe a 5x5 right there. Boom. Yeah, it's gonna be a monster. And then we'll go North American high density. Let's go North American medium density and let's put another 5x5 in here. Let's see, do I want to keep it off of that corner? Yeah, no, I'm gonna put it right in the corner there because then I can create some nice interesting walking ways through here. And then down in this space here, let's go back to a European style medium density. See if we can come in here with a 3x5. A 3x5. 3x4. Okay, we'll do that. That's fine. You win this time. And there. Now we'll start getting some height in there. Now, I'm looking at this freeway here, and I thought to myself, maybe some North American row style homes just kind of coming right along here. Let's see what our build squares look like. Yeah, let's do North American row because I would not call that an elegant looking piece. if I go 4 deep, will that work? Yeah, it does. Let's go 4 deep there. And then Let's see here. How many squares are there in total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so let's come here and here. Now that those are filled in, I'm going to go here and here. I have the ability to do one more. And then I'll do European style right down the middle. 1, 2. Boom, boom. There you go. And then let's just come into the next block and do something similar. And we'll repeat that pattern all the way down around this curve. Yeah, I like that. And it'll fill in really, you know, densely along this road here. And again, it's probably not the nicer looking flats or units that are going to be along here because you're up against a freeway, but it gives you the ability to really kind of add some density in this space. Now, let's see, what do we have down over here? I think this little spot down here would lend itself really well to some mixed use. Let's go with, let's do North American style mixed use in this space. And how deep can we make these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12. Okay, so maybe can we do 4 by 5 in a mixed-use configuration? Let's see. I don't know that it'll do that. Now let's do this then. I come back out here and erase that. Erase, erase, erase. And then if I take a 4 by 5 like this... 4x5 maybe is not a good config. However, I do like this 2x4. That's interesting. Or maybe if I even went 3x5, can we do that? We can. Ooh, I think we found our solution. If I do 3x5 there, I do 3x5 here, and then I come in with the European style mixed use right in the middle of it in a bigger configuration. That's fine. I think that'll fill in nicely. And just frame it up nicely here. Let's do some commercial down in this space here. What do you think? European style commercial right down along this waterfront here. I do like that idea. 2x4? Yeah, 2x4. Sure, let's keep that up. And then hold please. And then we'll go 2x4. 2x4. And then we'll come in with mixed use. Maybe the European style mixed use piece right in that 3x3. Can it do 3x3? Oh, it can't. That's so bad. I think it'll fill in nicely though. I do love those towers. Look at that. That's starting to look cool. And then tucked in behind it, we can put in some little tiny shops back there too. Maybe a 2x2 in European, 2x2 North American, 2x2 European. Yeah, there you go. Okay, cool. And this will reserve as a park, as we said earlier. How about this little spot down here? What do you think if we drop in some medium density homes in there? Let's go back to... I think I want to use a good size European style... I'm going to do North American style medium density in this big building here. What can we do? Oh, you know what? This is... This might be perfect for our EU 3x4. I do love those. Those turn out so nicely. And then I'll drop in a North American one in between. Just to sully it up a little bit. All right. And then down in behind here, let's put a nice row of medium density homes back in there. Let's go EU medium. And we're going to go, let's go 3x3. Yeah. I don't want it to be too dense, I don't think. Yeah, like that. And then we've got a little space back in there, just to put some decor and some beautification in there. So that could be nice. Ooh, what about this little spot right down here along the edge? Didn't even see that. Let's do a big anchor retail store, maybe a North American business retail store there, 5x5. Boom, yeah, that could be the corner grocery store. Hopefully if a grocery store fills in there. Okay. All right. Nice. I like the way that this is looking up. Traffic starting to build up as people are moving into the neighborhood. On to the next part. So let's jump over here now and finish off this side. This is where where I wanted to put in some nice little estate homes. And I thought maybe what we'll do is we'll start off with, say, grab an alleyway and just kind of run straight out, maybe straight from here. Come out 6 squares. Yeah, that's probably fine. And then put in the European style waterfront housing, low density, a nice big 4x4 there. And these 4x4s, they actually end up being these big, beautiful villas in this space. And so if I do a series of those running kind of down along the shore, and then down in this corner down here, tuck in maybe some smaller, almost city homes in the same style, though, I think this could be kind of a cool look. And it's, of course, accessible to, Gateway Village. So let's just jump down in here. I want to take an alley road, come out. Let's see here. I'm going to go out. What is that? 3? And then I'll come across 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. So then I should be able to put a 4x4 right here. Yeah. Okay. And then I want to come out of here. Maybe I'll come out of this side and do a, let's go up. Let's do a curved one this time. Up 4. No, let's go up 3 and then come over 3. Come over 1 or 2 and then, because I need to give myself room to actually build the villas. 1, 2, 3, 4x4. Yeah, okay. And then, yeah, I think we can get another 1 or 2 in here. Let's just see how tight we can get these. Maybe these guys share a driveway here. And this, here, this one will come out in this direction and then bend back across and then come straight across a little bit. Put a 4x4 up there. Yeah, okay. Very cool. Very cool. And then, can we get one more in? Maybe. I think we can. Let's just do one more good size one here. We're going to go straight out of here. Yeah, come straight out of here. And then diagonal out like so. Yeah. And then we're just going to put a 4x4 right there. Yeah. So what do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of those. Oof. Now this is going to be tight. Yeah. Okay. So let's come in here. We're just going to go straight out like this. Bring this out about as far as I can. And in fact, I think I want to snug that up even closer to this other villa. More something like this. Yeah, I think that'll be better. And the reason I want to do that is because then I can come across here. I turn off this and just run out like so. Run another. Put that back on now. Let's come out one more, like so, and then back in, turn this off again, like so. See if I can put in some, city homes, what we would call city homes, which is just smaller versions of what we've been doing here. So let's secure up our build squares if we can. Yeah, like that. And then I'll come in with this European style and just go, let's go 2x3. 2x3, and then come back across the street and do the same. Yeah, and now I've got this little row of villas, this little tiny city homes, if you will, that are nestled in here. And I think that would be a nice kind of approach to this neighborhood. Yeah, okay. So with those in place, we'll wait for those to fill in a little bit, and then we can come back in and do a little detail work with that. Let's come down here now and experiment with a little bit of surface painter. I want to grab our grass surface here, and I'm going to start down in this corner. Run this right on out here. Let's say to here, and then back across. There, now they have a nicely manicured lawn there. And we can give them a little bit of privacy. What we can do is we can grab some of these large, let's see if I can find it here now. Large, turn off European. Wild green bush 02. Oh yeah, there you go. Your first house popped in. Let's come down along here. So I'm going to go 1, 2. Yeah, something like that. And then I can come in with the cultivated green bushes and just kind of come right in between. Maybe 1, 2, 2. Yeah, and then it gives them, a finished off border to their lawn with just a little bit of privacy. And hopefully that'll help cut down some of the noise here. We could come back in and fill in some trees or plantings along there as well. But you can see this big villa down here on the end. And it'll be exciting when these guys pop in. And this will give us lots of opportunity during the beautification time lapse to come in here and just really sculpt out and manicure these lawns and gardens all throughout. Look at this. Wow, look at that. Big, beautiful home with a nice balcony, a veranda there that overlooks this little channel, this little inlet here. Wow, I like that. That's really a cool view. Very nice properties. Okay, cool. Well, it'll be fun to see how that fills in, and then we can beautify that. Very good. All right, what's next? Oh, that's right. I wanted to connect to this, this wall here. That's really just kind of a retaining wall, but acts as a sidewalk, or the other way around, sidewalk acting as a retaining wall. I want to connect that back into our neighborhood so that we can have just shopping access. So let's just do that. Yeah, now those are connected. And then we should probably do the same thing on the other side, although looks like we've got some fairly uneven terrain here. Let's just kind of see what we're working with. Yeah, let's decrease brush size here. Maybe let's try and smooth this out. Pick one elevation up here. And where was that? It was about there. Let's just kind of flatten that out. We can slope from here up to somewhere right around in here. Yeah, something like that. And then if I come in here with a path that's straight across, is that the one? Straight across? Yeah, look at that. Straight across from here. And then maybe what I'll do is I'll do a... And now I'll just go straight out. Just go straight out for now. See if I can come out. Yeah, that's probably fine. And now I can curve. I'll turn on my complex curve. And I'll just keep the right angles on. And just kind of meander this path. Kind of up its way. Something like this. And up into here. Just so we have a nice meandering path through here. I'll have to change the elevation there, smooth that out. But yeah, and this can be some nice beautiful gardens in here. And now we have to figure out how to create a bridge that gets us across from here to there. I don't think I can do it in a straight line, so I may have to kind of cheat a little bit. Let's go grab one of our elevated bridges. Which one do we like? Do we like the pedestrian arch bridge? Let's see what that looks like. And I'm going to bring this up to about... I don't know, maybe 10 meters or so, somewhere right around in here. Let's just see how this works. 10 meters, come across. Yeah, okay. I don't know if I like the loop-de-loops, but that's okay. We'll just we'll put it in place for the moment. Let's just come in a little bit closer, come from this side. See if I can't bring that down just a little bit. I'm trying to get this so it's level. That's pretty level. Okay. Yeah, I don't like the loops. All right, so let's then bend this down into here if we can. So what is that going to entail? Turn all of this back on. Curve, pavement path. Just up here somewhere. It's a steep decline, but... Oh, it actually doesn't look so bad. Look at that. Okay. All right, let's do the same thing on the other side. We'll come back up here. Just see what we've got. That's a little wobbly bobbly, but that's not so bad. And same thing on the other side, but I think we can come back in the beautification time lapse, tidy that up a little bit. And speaking of beautification time lapses, let's just go ahead and transition to that right now. This seems like a good time to do it, and there's a lot that I need to do in this space. So I want to start down here with these lawns. I want to build out some nicely manicured lawns along here. You know, in fact, I think I might even want another estate in here. This just feels a little too spread out, and I think this would be such good real estate they'd want to pack in some of these bigger houses. Let's jump back over to this other neighborhood here, and yeah, we can do some densification here. I'm not sure that I'm sold on the European style ones now that I look at them, and yeah, I guess we need these to level up, so hopefully they look a little nicer. But lots of beautification, some winding paths that come through here. Oh yeah, we need to peel back this canal wall here, right? You know, can't have a canal walk. And speaking of canal walks, look at these people. They're just all walking through here. This is great. Exactly the look I was going for. So let's peel all this back and make sure we expose our water. And then we can put in a little park down here in the corner. Really beautify this area back in through here as well. Just like to thicken it up with some gardens and such. You know, that's really kind of the big stuff. All right. Well, why don't you guys sit back, relax, enjoy the time lapse, and let's connect here afterwards and recap our sculpture. All right, welcome back. And I give you the new Southpass Isle. Yeah, the Southpass Isle, which of course was this odd parcel of land really sitting at the base of the Southpass Tunnel as it makes its way, the Baypass Tunnel as it makes its way in from the south under the bay over into downtown. And I had a lot of fun with this build today because we really used a lot of different kind of styles in here, both architecturally and design-wise. And I can't wait to dive in and show you guys. So let's take a look. I want to start on this side here, which was our estates side, if you will. I put in some big mansions in here with some lush gardens. You can see I framed everything all up with some hedges and bushes. And I just kind of, you know, tucked those lawns out into the kind of the wild area out here. And this one here, I've got this pair of homes with a nice little, you know, kind of border in between the two with just some wild plantings and palm trees. But man, the visuals from these homes. Can you imagine sitting in here and watching the cruise ships coming by? And you can see the big bridge off there in the distance and, you know, just those lush plantings and the cruise ships coming through. I just think this is a fantastic place to live. What a great place to call home. And then, you know, I tucked in another building here. So we've got a couple more mansions here that, again, are oriented off into Gateway Village, which is great. And then we have our little city home collection in here. I love the way that these turned out. Little tinier villas, just a smaller square footage in this Mediterranean style, but tucked in here nicely into this bend, you know, as this, at kind of at the base of this bridge as it makes its way back into Gateway Village. And as these level up, I'm sure they're going to continue to become more elegant. But I wanted to make sure I was consistent in those, you know, decorative elements that kind of sat out front here and made sure that this looked like it was one big, large neighborhood. All right. Let's, before we jump across the other side, you can see our pedestrian bridge. Oh, look at the train coming through. But our pedestrian bridge is now fully operational, and I just love the way that this turned out. Nice, gentle slopes coming up and down, but connecting both sides of the island across the, you know, the Baypass Tunnel. And these walking paths are really starting to get a workout here. In fact, I don't know if you guys noticed it or not, but boy, during the time lapse, we had a whole stampede of people making their way up to the Dining Fine restaurant. I'm not sure what was going on in there, but there were an awful lot of hearts flying in the air. So I'm not sure what's going on, if it's legal in all states, but they seem to be having a lot of fun in there. All right, let's jump down all the way around now to the backside of this here, where we have our little row home neighborhood. We started off in this area right at the beginning of the episode, and look at how these row homes have all leveled up to, I think, at least level 3. We've got these beautiful palm trees with some plants and bushes and shrubs, and all the homes that are on this side here get to face out towards the canal, so a nice, lovely water view. But all the homes that are tucked in behind facing the other direction, they have a water view too from their backyards. So love the way that that turned out. And of course, you see the pedestrian roads getting a good workout here. We meander our way down to our corner park, and this really was a lot of fun. I just got to play with that surface painter a little bit here just to see how this would frame up. I'd love to have some actual planter boxes, but we may do with some just little shrubs in there. Some wilder elements here, and then some beautiful flowers that are kind of right up along curbside there. Now, continuing along on our journey, we've got some commercial shops that are in here. And these commercial shops, I came back in and kind of gave them a mix up of North American and European styles just to give it some flavor, some variety. And then, of course, we have our mixed-use building here. Now, speaking of mixed-use, I didn't really care for the North American mixed-use that I originally had in here, so I changed it out and put in some European. And I just think that's a much more elegant look, considering, you know, you're going to be viewing that from across this little channel here from this side, and I think it turned out really elegantly. And, of course, we've got our nice big, I guess it's a supermarket in the corner here, but I'm not sure I'd want to eat anything coming from crap fish granules. But anyhow, it's our big market there in the corner. And at least people have a place to go find food, even if it's not real appetizing. Now, let's jump down here to our bus station. That seems to be getting a pretty good workout here. I've got a couple bus routes coming and going. You can see one of them heading out in this direction and one coming up the street here. But there's been a lot of activity and a lot of transfer going on here in the bus station. And then we removed that large parking lot and put in an underground parking garage. We really needed the extra capacity for parking. I seriously underestimated how many vehicles would be in this space. And so this has really gone a long way to help us kind of satiate that demand. Now, you'll notice, too, I added some additional height in here. I put in a North American tower here, a European-style tower here, another one here, and just wanted to get some elevation again in this area just because I thought it should be a nice prominent piece. And if you were living up in the penthouse on this area, how about that view into downtown? Holy cow, that's just spectacular over there. And I can't wait to fill out the consular district too. So these are going to be very desirable pieces of real estate in the future. Now let's jump down here. I want to show you these row homes down here, because the idea again was to put some European units in the center sections and then flank them with North American. And I think the one that turned out the best is probably this guy right here. If you look at this, you've got the same matching stone colors here in that center with these peaked roofs and then the flat roofs that kind of stand across the side here. I just think that that turned out really neat. And we've replicated that. This one, again, these two have matchings over here. These two are different, but still, I think they turned out wonderfully. Now, I'm going to jump over the top of these medium density buildings here that we have tucked in behind them and take a look at this little plaza that we've got down in here as well. Again, I played around with the surface painter, put these in here and dropped in some trees in here with some bushes around the bases of it. And I just think it makes it feel much more inviting and actually a little bit more contemporary too. So really nice little aspect there. Again, tucked in a little bit more parking here. Extended some of these surface paints. Look out for the helicopters. And then, we've got this little kind of alcove, if you will, of medium density buildings that are kind of making their way along the, just along the curve. And I think that turned out great. All right, let's take a look at our top five design element. Yeah, it's our little wilderness garden down in here. And this was a lot of fun to build out. I put these paths in here and I came down in. Unfortunately, you can't really tell so much during the fall season, but there's bright, beautiful plantings and flower bushes all throughout here with our palm trees and shrubs and just a variety of different colors. I used the surface painter to create little mock paths through here, little sand mock paths. Now, they're not active paths and people can't walk on them, but it just kind of has this crushed gravel sort of a feel about it. Just a little bit more, a little bit more rugged, a little bit more wilderness. And then, of course, you've got this big plaza area with this tile-looking feature that extends along this curve here, just to add some interest along to this curve as you're looking around. And even the folks here who are sitting real close to the freeway, I think they've got a fantastic view. You've got the wonderful nature gardens over there. You can see all the way over into downtown Pengasas Bay. And you can see the cruise ships going by, and you really don't get much of the freeway traffic thanks to this sound barrier that we put up. All right, that is going to do it for today's episode. That was an awful lot. So you guys are going to want to sit tight and watch the cinematics where we kind of bring it all together. Those should be a lot of fun and a big treat for you guys today. Now, just as a reminder, this channel is nothing without you, our wonderful viewers, and I really do appreciate your support. So if you saw something that you liked today, be sure to leave us a comment below. Really, really do love that. Love hearing from you. And the engagement really helps with the algorithm to distribute our content to a much wider audience, which helps us grow and helps us keep improving. A big shout out and a thank you to all of our members as well, both here at YouTube and on our Patreon site. Your generosity is very much appreciated. And also, while you're at it, be sure to chip away at that like button and hammer that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the happenings here in Pengasas Bay and our Grand Vanilica series as well. Okay, well, with that, I'm going to bid you guys a fond farewell. And until next time, good morning, good day, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.